Hello, my name is Scott for SB Gaming, and welcome back to The Vanishing of Ethan Carter. And this is a beautiful world. Spend a couple minutes taking a look, just taking in the scenery. And, yeah. So at this point, we had solved one scene. Turns out Ethan Carter's family turned against him, and his brother, I think, got killed. Probably older brother. And, yeah. He tried to kill Ethan, and Ethan ended up getting out of it. So we are going to continue up here. See where the railway takes us. Now. Was that the only way, or could we have come around this way? Well, we can crouch. Okay, yeah, I figured. If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, okay. Can we go up there? Nope. We can't actually jump, but we can do a little bit of climbing over of things. This game is all about exploring around, looking for clues, looking for the next mystery. All right. Creepy forest with its creaking trees. That way. Can we squeeze up here? Yes, we can. Can't climb up there. We have another view. Inspect. All right. So we cannot go any further? No. Can we climb up there? No, we can't. Alright, so we came up that way. Thank you. aren't going to be able to climb up there. Can we go up this way? Probably not. What is that over there? Spacemen. Fangs. The beast had fangs, but was heavy and slow. So when it saw the light in the sky, it waited, thinking the light would go out, like the others before it. When it did not, the beast rose up on its legs and went to the place where the fire was still burning. As the orange light died, another took its place. This one was blue, a bright and pure blue that the creature had only seen along the edges of the stars. The beast showed its fangs, and the light vanished. A moment later, the light appeared again, between two distant trees. The beast wanted to go home, but could not ignore the light, so it chased it deeper into the forest. And when the light stopped, it did so in a clearing of trees. The beast entered the circle, feeling no fear. The trees turned towards the beast, pointing at it like needles. But the tops of the trees lowered and dug into the ground. The trunks and roots were raised into the air and closed around the beast like walls. As the ground disappeared, the beast realized it would never use its fangs again.
Get out of my room, Travis!
Stories, stories, always with the stories.
Get out!
I read the Fangs one. I liked the Beast. At least he gets to leave this goddamn place.
All right. Fangs. When the light stopped, it did so in the clearing of trees. All right. And abstruse tales. Gaylord. All right. Yellow Hills of Mars by Douglas Spaulding. Well, that is where that came from. Now. Where are we right now? Okay, there's the tracks. That's where we came from. Could come from there. Can't go through there. As we progress through Red Creek Valley, I will probably remember a few things from watching Gopher's playthrough, but right now it's all a vague recollection. Alright, so this is clearing. We have kind of a fort here. Yep. Of Ethan Carter's. My recommendation, if you plan to play this game, obviously, is to not watch my playthrough before. I definitely highly recommend, of course. This warning is coming a little bit too late, although there's still the rest of the game to explore. We've just dipped our toes into things. And this clock is stopped at 7:05 or 7:04. All right. Through here, yes, we do. And we could have follow that road or the tracks. And we have a building here.
No trains have been through here for a long time. That was part of a pattern. Large pieces of this country were thrown away, doomed to become, and then remain, the worst versions of themselves. Beneath all that rot, dark things grow.
All right. So this doesn't look like there is a door. All right. So yeah, this place must have once been home to something. A mine or some other productive use of the land. And then, of course, once the mine ran out, people leave. The place becomes desolate. Can't do anything with those. We have over here. Not much. And we are probably not going to be able to climb. Here. And tracks continue. Just check over here. And nothing. All right, well, the definitely had a rock slide over here. What do we have up here? All right. So is this part going to serve any purpose? Probably not. And that goes across the dam. And just to check, nothing else over here.
I've seen every version of people hurting each other, hurting themselves, and they blame it on compulsion, selfishness, madness. I suppose the idea is, if you name a thing, you can control it. There are things in this world that cannot be named.
All right. Throw grenade. What? We can throw the grenade? All right, bet that. I was curious what the grenade would be for, if there is no combat in this game. Apparently we found out. And we have a house on the hill. We have a rundown house over there. What's that, Loon? And that must be the rail bridge we crossed over. Anyone home?
What did you do? What did you wake up?
Nothing. I found a room, I walked into it, that's it.
All right. And we can come out here.
You can feel it, right? Something coming from the Vandegrift house.
I can feel it. Ethan disturbed the sleeper. He must be punished.
Who is the sleeper?
You need to talk to your son. He was poking around in the old Vandegrift house again. Said he found some secret room.
Yeah, really? Okay, I will go talk to him.
This is a kitchen? Or... no. Dining area. Yeah, we have a set of stairs up.
Pop, they're getting worse. They keep talking about this thing, this sleeper.
I know. What I don't know is if it's real or not.
Someone else here? Or am I just hearing things?
Travis, leave the boy alone. I see how you've been looking at him.
You don't even know, do you? You have no idea what's going on.
All right.
You have to help us. It's the only way.
And what do we have over here? Yeah, it's just a creepy house.
Ethan's family blamed him. Whatever it was he'd accidentally let loose, his family was convinced that hurting him would solve their problems, would soothe their disturbed minds. Whatever haunted the Carters was still here somewhere, in the wind.
So this is the Vandegrift house. Alright, so I think we've explored the entire place. Alright about that. So there's a little bit of story there. But at this point, I will probably take a break here, and we will continue off with more Ethan Carter in the next episode. Thank you for joining me for this episode of The Vanishing of Ethan Carter. Thank you for watching. My name is Scott for SB Gaming, and as always, have a good day.